FM News. On point. News on XFM, I'm Chris Otim. As the world prepares to celebrate the International Women's Day, the government chief whip, Ruth Nankabirwa, has appealed to women to participate in mitigating COVID-19 effects that have compromised the economy. The 2021 Women's Day will be celebrated under the theme Women in Leadership, Achieving an Eco-Future in a COVID World. Nankabirwa says that women have a role in the recovery of the economy and home income for livelihood. Nankabirwa also reminds women in leadership positions to be exemplary and prove the women's capacity in delivering at all levels. The State House Anti-Corruption Unit, together with the Uganda Police, have detained 19 impersonators, commonly known as bafere, over fraud, bribery, and extortion. Within 2 months, the unit has been able to convict and sentence Robert Impungu, Roger Sainebiona, Edison Muhindo, Bethwell Lominsa, Ahmed Kawoya, Captain Emmanuel Abaho, Wilbur Turiahika and Stephen Buteta to serve between 1 to 4 years in prison. While addressing the press, the head of the anti-corruption unit, Lieutenant Colonel Edith Nakalema, warned the public to desist from all forms of corruption.
We continue to blame those that have given in to the impersonators. When you give a bribe, you are also corrupt. So we request the public to refuse, refute, and eliminate the corrupt. Don't give in to those people who approach you and are asking for favors, are asking for information, claiming that they will help you to erase or win a case. Don't give in to wrong people. We remain very steadfast in ensuring that the fight against corruption is intensified, and we believe that collective efforts can keep corruption out of our country.
Ruko Wesigire, the deputy spokesperson for the Kampala Metropolitan, has asked people to always come up and report cases concerning corruption to the police.
If you're out there and such people have approached you, you can always come out and inform the officers at the State House Anti-Corruption Unit so that we can get additional evidence that we can always present before courts of law so that we can expedite the investigation and also get early sentences so that the case doesn't lag on so long. So these are some of the people that have been taken to courts of law. Some we have, gotten conviction. Others we are still hopeful anytime, but of course we are alert.
A total of $120 million has so far been used in the installation of internet around the country. The permanent secretary in the Ministry of ICT and National Guidance, Vincent Bajire Waiswa, says that they have made installations in 4 phases since 2007 and the whole process will end in the next 2 years. He added that this has helped in saving government money, transport costs has reduced, and many people are expected to make more research and get exposed to different opportunities.
In the ministry's efforts to digitize the country, we are doing two fundamental things. We want to ensure that there is ICT infrastructure across the entire country. The second one, a major building block, is services. And again, the Honorable Minister has touched the e-services, electronic services, that the National IT Authority is coordinating. And these e-services range from the Ministry of Immigration is doing to ensure that when you apply for a passport, you can do it online and get it in the shortest time possible. What we are doing as a ministry is to ensure that we automate all the services so that citizens can have a good experience in accessing the services we offer as government of Uganda.
ICT Minister Judith Nabakova says that they are planning to set up an information technology park where Ugandans and investors will exhibit their products to the entire world for people to see. She also promised that the ministry is planning to expand Wi-Fi to the whole country.
Government of Uganda, through NITAU, is currently implementing the last mile connectivity project aimed at further expanding the coverage of the NDI through laying of approximately 732 kilometers of fiber optic cable and connecting an additional 700 sites to the NDI with an additional 300 Wi-Fi hotspots. You already know that we have some Wi-Fi hotspots, they're about 300, and now the last mile is aiming at creating another 300 Wi-Fi hotspots. These points are used by our people in the different areas, wherever they are.
On to world news. Despite spending more time at home due to the pandemic, the United States is in the midst of a baby bust, not a baby boom. U.S. births have been falling for nearly a decade, and 2019 saw the fewest births in 35 years, but the final numbers for 2020 could slip even lower. An estimated 300,000 fewer babies are expected in 2021, according to a study by the Brookings Institution think tank. It comes as the pandemic has created a turbulent labor market that has disproportionately hurt working women. Last year, women slightly outnumbered men in the workforce, but their labor market participation has now dropped to 57%, the lowest level since 1988, according to the National Women's Law Center. Amid extensive school and daycare closures, as well as limits on public gatherings, millions of women have been forced to balance supervising and teaching their children with work and other responsibilities. In our local sports, Express Football Club are returned to action today while hosting Busoga United in the Uganda Premier League Match Day 12 at the Mutesa 2 Stadium, Wankulukuku. Waswa Bosa's Charges have so far picked 7 wins and 4 draws from 11 games, making them one of the two clubs that are yet to lose a league game this term. The Red Eagles captain Enoch Walusimbi is hopeful the home win will count against the off-form Busoga United.
We are much prepared for this game. We are at home. We have improved on our scoring. I think we shall score more goals. We are much so concentrated on the scoring. Also, it's very good that the team doesn't proceed so much. The defending is okay. The team is improving by each game. So I think we shall win the game.
Elsewhere in the world of sports, Manchester United have borrowed £60 million to help cushion the financial impact of the coronavirus pandemic. United announced their second quarter results to the 31st of December on Thursday. The club confirmed matchday income had fallen 94.2% to £3.2 million over the corresponding 6 months in 2019. An overall revenue reduction of £22 million was limited only because the club played in the group stage of the more lucrative Champions League this season compared to the Europa League. The club's net debt has risen 16.4% to £455 million. It is estimated United lost over £100 million in income over the past 12 months, so to prevent cash reserves dropping to a level they do not feel happy with, the decision was taken to take a portion of the £200 million rolling credit facility they arranged last year. And that's the latest XFM news.
XFM news on point.